Hi guys, welcome back for round 3. And as you can see on our table here, we have our prizes for our top 8. All these starters are for our top 3. And champions get to choose first from the professor.
Absolutely, these are coming from our sponsors here, Comic Fiesta. And they've sponsored also these vouchers as well for our premier challenge for today. We would like to thank Comic Fiesta so much for the sponsorship for our tournaments here.
Yep.
We'll also be holding our Malaysia Open tournament at Comic Fiesta, their main event, in December. We would like to see all of our players from Singapore, Thailand, come over and we'll duke it out in our Malaysian Open as well. Really looking forward to that one, and thank you again so much to Comic Fiesta. Right, and we're going to round 3 for the matter, and we are going to see both players, Gary Ng versus Akhil Putra. Both these players are no strangers in the community. Gary has participated in the 2016 World Championships. Akhil has also qualified for that World Championships as well, but unfortunately he didn't make it due to personal reasons. But definitely both players are very strong contenders in the current game and format as well. So I'd like to see how the round 3 go up against each other, you know what I mean?
So much hype. Like on the second round we have such a strong matchup, and then now we also have one. That's pretty good.
Absolutely, that's what I love coming to events, just to see some quality games being played by my friends right here.
Yep.
And yep, we're gonna see both these players just chit-chatting about their before their matchups right now. But yeah, I'm not, because Akhil throughout the season, he has loved to play double ducks.
Yep.
Which is the Gold Duck Developer Core. But lately, he has shifted towards Buzzwole, his mascot Pokemon. You know, he loves Buzzwole so much. And
oh, the bugs.
Yep. He loves to bring a mosquito around wherever he goes. So I'm not sure if he's going to bring Buzzwole again today. I can't wait to see and watch how does the game turn out. And Gary also no stranger. Oh, as we do see on stream,
ooh,
Gary's the player on the left and Akhil's the player on the right. You can take Gary's side.
On Gary's side, we can see Tapu Lele, Magnezone, Arcanine, Buzzwole, Drifblim, and Nihiligo.
Oh. Whereas on Akhil's side, he's also carrying a similar core. Actually the same team, except
for Magnezone.
Magnezone is small for Metagross.
This will be very interesting.
This is like a mirror match.
Almost mirror match.
Huh. Gary has the answer to the Drifblim be the Magnezone. But the Magnezone is also threatened by the Buzzwole and the Arcanine. So yeah,
yep.
Steel Core, I feel it's more favored towards... Ah, it's actually, there's no favor at the moment.
It's just a mirror match.
It's a mirror match and they both have answers to each other.
Yep.
Like, Akhil has the Metagross, but it's also answered by the Arcanine and the Drifblim. And the Nihilego on both sides have answered by the Steel types. So it's a very even matchup. We'll have to see how the both players maneuver this mirror match. It's literally a mirror match here, folks.
I would like to see whether they mirror match.
Leads.
Yeah, they mirror the leads.
Yeah, that'll be very mind-boggling. Like, what would you do against Gary, right?
Yep.
Yeah, both players are still selecting. Like, how do you select against this matchup? I don't even know.
I don't know.
There's 2 seconds. 1 second.
Hello?
Yeah, I'm not sure if Gary selected all of the mods. The mods I wanted to select. But I know Akhil selected in front of them.
We shall see on the matchup.
Yep, I'm coming to see what both players need right here. We might just see the Drifblim and Lele mirror lead for all I know.
Drifblim Magnezone.
We just see Drifblim Magnezone coming up from Gary's side. And we just see Metagross and Tapu Lele coming up from Gary's side. Oh wow.
Wow.
In terms of leads right here, I say Gary has a better lead in this matchup. Because the Magnezone threatens the Tapu Lele and the Drifblim threatens the Metagross, just for that reason. And Tapu Lele and Metagross have no Pokemon to hit on the field for significant amounts of damage. So yeah, Gary's in the final position right now.
Most definitely.
Yep, what possible plays you might want to see here?
I have no idea. I would expect a switch from Akhil.
Yep.
He would switch out either Lele or Metagross.
Yep, as you're right, correctly predicting that the Tapu Lele will switch out for its own Drifblim. Trying to match the Tailwind. But we do know that Gary's Tailwind, if he were to go for Tailwind, he would get the first Tailwind. Which he does. Oh boy.
well.
Can we just see a Thunderbolt
going into Metagross slot?
Metagross slot. That's the name from Metagross. Shattered Psyche from Metagross. It might just target the Drift Flip, all I know.
I do think it's going into the Drift Flip slot.
Yep. Shattered Psyche. Send his butt.
Yep.
Physical Psychic Terrain Boosting. Going onto the
Drift Flip slot. Yeah.
Would that pick up the Chaos?
I'm praying for a KO!
It does!
Whoa!
That's a one-hit knockout for Ugly Putra. But Gary, in turn of sacking his own Drift Flip, he got up Tailwind. Which the Magnezone could offer in terms of speed. But knowing that the Drift Flip has activated Psychic Seed, it's definitely carrying that Burden Boost. So he could also match Tailwind as well for Ugly Psych. I mean, Arclip could match up his own Tailwind. Yep, Gary has lost one Pokemon, but to get himself in a much better position in the moment. Now we do see both Pokemon, both players have their Steel types on the field, Magnezone and Metagross.
Yep.
And their partner being the Psychic slash Ghost abuser in the matchup right now.
Most definitely.
So yeah, in terms of positioning, we'll have to see whether this Arclip survives the barrage of attacks. But no, he chooses to switch out into
Arcanine.
That's a very defensive switching for Arcanine. He soaked the possible hits from Tapu-Lene's possible Psychic.
Yep.
Or the Magnus Thunderbolt. Shattered Psychic from Tapu-Lene on Gary's side of the field.
Which slot will we go into?
This Drift Flip. I'm counting on that. The Drift Flip is such a threat on the field right now.
Yep,
going on to the Drift Flip. The Zeppelins are going down. Oh my goodness, what is happening, folks? Drift Flip!
Oh, it lives!
That was a crucial limb on Arcanine's side, and he matches the Tailwind. Everything here, Thunderbolt. Going on to the Arcanine slot. Doing little amounts of damage. I'm at loss for words right now. So
that Drift Blim is just, I don't know, Led Zeppelin.
Led Zeppelin did not go down. Arcanine's in control. The Tailwinds have been matched. And oh my goodness, I'm at loss for words. But the Tapu-Lele on Gary's side of the field could pose a threat on the Arcanine depending on speed tier. Who EV trained, the amount will be faster than the other. We'll see right now who is faster, Arcanine or Tapu-Lele.
Choose!
Faster will determine the game, actually.
I have a feeling it will be Tapu-Lele, but I couldn't say anything about Arcanine.
We do see a Patek
coming off.
Arcanine is cheering. They need double target the Tapu-Lele slot. We do see a
Shadow Ball
going in there. That's just about 40%.
Psychic going on.
Tapu-Lele being faster than the Arcanine.
As I thought.
Not picking up the KO. Everything's a double target on Tapu-Lele. After collecting the protect from Magnus.
And it picks up the KO on the Lele.
Wow, Arcanine is playing significantly better than what he was doing prior to the PC before this. Now Arcanine has 4 Pokemon remaining. Going up against Gary's 2 remaining Pokemon, being the Arcanine and the Magnezone, both at full HP, but Arcanine's side of the field, the board, is significantly weaker.
Yep.
What do you think of this matchup right now?
I think he might set the Drift Flip. You never know. Either one or two of them will just set.
Yep. Drift Flip is going to go for a Shadow Ball
into Magnezone.
The sturdy on Magnezone.
Yep.
And we just see a Flavlin going onto the Zeppelin. No, onto Arcanine.
Yeah, on the Arcanine.
Yep. And we do see the Thunderbolt going on to
Drift Flip.
But yeah, this gives Arcanine the same switching to what he has in the back.
Ooh, this match is so good.
Yep, and knowing that, the Tailwind Gary's has beat out first, because he went for the Tailwind on the first turn, Arcanine went for Tailwind on the second turn of the game. So now Arcanine has one turn to abuse Triple in his favor. And we just have Metagross and Tapu-Lele coming up for Arcanine. Gary is in a better position here.
With the Arcanine now, and Metagross.
The Arcanine could pose a threat onto the Metagross.
Most definitely.
Psyche on top of me, I really doubt it can pick up the tail on Magnezone. So we'll have to see how the Darkwing maneuvers his way around, because Gary's big condition is the Magnezone right now, actually.
Yep. Most going for the protect there.
Did Arthur double target onto the Arthur and start? No, it's the Arthur back.
Oh,
double
well.
Protect. Okay, fair enough. We just had Psyche going onto
the Arcanine slot.
It was just send him back onto Arcanine.
Yeah.
Double target as well. And the Tailwind does peter out for Arcanine. Back at neutral speed. So, now that the Psyche terrain is up, it's over.
Yep.
The firepower on top of Lady and Metagross is reduced. Significantly reduced.
Which
down to see whether he can pick up the KO on Magnezone. We do see Metagross going for a protect right now. And we do see top of Lady going for a psychic on the Arcanine slot.
Yeah. Ooh.
It does, but it does not pick up the KO. And we do see a Fabulous going to Metagross and a Flash Cannon going on to top of Lady. That's up there. That's gonna pick up the KO. Magnezone is so strong. Same base special attack, such as Tapu Nene, but it does not need the terrain to function as well as Tapu Nene. So yeah,
Tapu Nene is just, you need the terrain, if not, it's just there.
Gary definitely preserved the psychic terrain turns better, I presume.
I guess.
Because the Arcanine was able to come in at the last turn and pick up the KOs onto Metagross, specifically for Metagross.
In goes the flat bit, then picks up the KO.
That is a good game on both players' end. We do see how the game mechanics work even in the mirror match.
Yeah.
Where the Tailwind on each side played a huge role.
Tiki Bear.
Yep, a very convincing win on Gary's side. He has arguably the better lead. The better.
I would say play. So too.
Yep, the better board play. And he nabbed the important KOs very method, I felt.
Yes. But I was surprised that neither Bus Wall or Nihil Ego came out.
If I was in their position, the Bus Wall and Nihil Ego is severely threatened by the Steel type.
True, yes.
The Magnezone was such an issue for Nihil Ego. Nihil Ego cannot touch any of the Steel Mons, and both players could not bring Bus Wall solely because both players had Arcanine and Tapu Lele.
True.
If Bus Wall would have been dead weight in that matchup, I felt. Buzzwall on Arcanine's side could only be used to touch Magnezone. Other than that, Buzzwall had no function.
Yeah, it was just be there.
Yep. So I felt both players were very smart in just not bringing the Buzzwall and Nihil Ego just because of the sheer threat the Steel types could offer to both players' side of the field.
Yep.
Yeah. But yeah, it would have been nice to see, but possibly in different matchups, I'm sure that's why the Buzzwall and Nihil Ego was in that team. Absolutely. Thank you, Emil and Nathir.
Thank you.
And that concludes our round 3, folks.
Stay tuned for round 4.
We'll see
coming up soon.
Round 4.